To see you.
Amen. Yes.
9 through 17. Before the Passover feast began, Jesus was fully aware that the time had come for him to leave this world and return to the Creator. And as he had loved those who were his own in the world, he loved them to the last and to the highest degree. So during supper, Satan, having already put the thought of betraying Jesus in the heart of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, that Jesus, knowing that the God had put everything into his hands and that he had come from God and was now returning to God, got up from supper, took off his garments, and taking a servant's towel, he fastened it around his waist. Then he poured water into the wash basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the servant's towel with which he was girded. When he came to Simon Peter, Peter said to him, "Lord, is it for you to wash my feet?" Jesus said to him, "You do not understand now what I am doing, but you will understand it later on." Peter said to him, "You shall never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you have no share in companionship with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, wash not only my feet, but my hands and my head too." Jesus said to him, "Anyone who has bathed needs only to wash their feet, but is clean all over. And you, my disciples, are clean, but not all of you." For he knew who was going to betray him. That was the reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had finished washing their feet and had put on his garments and had sat down again, he said to them, "Do you understand what I have done to you? You call me the teacher and the Lord, and you are right in doing so, for that is what I am. If I then, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. For I have given you this as an example, so that you should do what I have done to you. I assure you, most solemnly I tell you, a servant is not greater than his master, and no one who is sent is superior to the one who sent him. If you know these things, blessed and happy and to be envied are you if you practice them." Hear what the Spirit says today. Thanks be to God.
A more sweeter sounding word, these lips have never said. A gentle name so beautiful, my heart cannot forget. Just a whisper is enough to set my soul at ease. Just thinking of this name brings my heart to peace. Say the name, Jesus. Say the name that soothes the soul, the name of gentle healing and peace immutable. I'll say the name that has heard my cry, has seen my tears and wiped them dry. From now until the end of time, I'll say the name. May I never grow so strong that my heart cannot be moved. May I never grow so weak that I fear to speak the truth.